Welcome to TerryWilson3.com.
This is the Terry Wilson, really?
Hey, Tony, this is Terry Wilson with TerryWilson3.com. How are you?
You personally are calling me back.
Get ready to discover, develop, and monetize your skills and talents with Terry Wilson.
If you think I'm going to miss the Braves, you're crazy.
I can pull us up.
You are crazy.
You're crazy.
You think I'm going to miss my Atlanta Braves. Welcome, guys. This is episode 358, and you're in the studio here with Lindsay, Chris, and a new guy. Who is this new guy over here? What's your name?
This young blood.
I go by a lot, but typically I just go by John.
Mostly what he goes by, he can't say on.
He can't say
FDA regulated.
Exactly. Well, guys, we're in the house, and the house is packed. For you praying folks out there, pray for my oldest son, Reagan. He is homesick with 102 fever. And so in his stead is my third. Are you the third or fourth? I can't ever remember.
I'm the third.
You're
the middle, yeah.
Mr. River.
Right in the middle.
Right in the middle. River is
a river runs through it.
The river is flowing tonight. He is in the house with us. But listen, guys, tonight we're talking about fool's gold. Since it is April Fool's, I thought, well, let's talk about fool's gold. The greatest obstacle to success, I believe, has to be disappointment. You know, perpetual disappointment, if not checked, will lead to feelings of hopelessness, cynicism, and feelings of defeat. So many people have given up on pursuing their passion, their purpose, and a better career because they've just been burnt by what? Fool's gold. And so tonight on episode 358, we've entitled it Fool's Gold. Now, everyone knows what Fool's Gold is, but for those living in Kayser, North Carolina, let me explain. Fool's Gold, also known as iron pyrite, is a gold-colored mineral that is often mistaken for real gold. Pyrite is a brass yellow mineral with a bright metallic luster. It is a chemical composition of iron and disulfide, if I can pronounce that, and is the most common sulfide mineral. Today, fool's gold is a common term used to describe any item which has been believed to be valuable to the owner, only to end up having no value. Investment in this hot whatever that seemed too good to be true, only to crash and burn, can be referred to as fool's gold. Journalists and the Wall Street analysts sometimes use this term to describe overvalued stocks as well. They title their articles and investment notes as headlines, fool's gold and high tech or mining companies debt is fool's gold. So that's what fool's gold is. But in the opportunity space, you know, the numbers are there. 98% of home-based businesses fail. And the people that have tried them have tried and failed. And so a lot of times people get cynical and think, well, everything is fool's gold. Everything must be bad. Everything must be, you know, just, you know, pie in the sky. But it's not. There are real opportunities out there tonight. And I want to break down how you can discern and distinguish between the real opportunities and the ones that maybe you should pass on. But before I do that, to my left,
this never gets old.
Never gets old. Miss CBD Oil herself. Back from the Worthmore Conference in Greenville, South Carolina.
Ooh, I made it in by the skin of my teeth.
Already asking me and Chris, can we go ahead and do this again next week?
Oh, mercy, mercy.
She just can't get it.
She's ready to do all this speaking.
She is ready to get back up in front of you guys and speak.
No.
And as a matter of fact, at the end of this podcast, we're going to give out Lindsay's personal cell phone
number. Oh, no, you better not.
And if you guys got any questions, since Reagan's not in there, we're just going to let you call her.
Lindsay Taylor does not answer her phone unless there is an appointment or it's her husband.
And I know this to be the truth because I've tried calling a couple times. Why won't she answer my phone?
Nope.
Lindsay, did you have a good time at the conference?
I did. I did have a good time. I got to meet a lot of my members and it was super fun. Speaking again, I'm pretty honest. It is not my gift, and
I prefer not to do it again.
But I do hope that I was able to share a few things that were helpful. I'm happy to share what's helpful. I just get super, super nervous in front of crowds.
Let me tell you, the reviews came back, and you were one of the all-stars, so you don't have to worry about
please.
Your speaking.
Yes, oh, please.
I'm telling you. People loved it, so don't worry about that. You did great.
Well, they must relate to the Hot Mess
Express. The largest breakout of the entire conference was yours.
That's true. Absolutely true.
That is mind blowing.
And it was true. You
next
just,
to mine.
Well, next to
Rivers. Rivers
next to River, and to her right, Mr. Funny Man. All the way from the Queen City, Charlotte, North Carolina.
That's right.
How you doing, Chris?
Where's your wife at? I just want to hang out with her again.
We need to get her over here and get her on. But we would have to delay this quite a bit. So, because there's no telling what she'd say.
Telling what she would say.
It can't be any worse than what you say.
I don't know. She would be honest.
I loved getting to know her this weekend. Listen, or a couple weekends ago.
It was so cool just to get to know everyone in this business and seeing them and putting a face with the name.
And that steak at Liberty. I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah. That was good.
Oh,
that
steak.
Was, lot to you. Was that not epic?
Now, it was a very brief moment when we ate it, but that moment while we were eating it was delicious.
I'm glad we went there. I'm glad it was on the menu.
I know you loved walking those 20 minutes.
I just don't think it was the right thing to do at that time.
Okay.
Because I had to be right back at 7:30.
We could have went over there at 9 o'clock. That's might have been what we should have done.
That would have worked.
Yeah.
Late dinner.
But it was good. And right in front of me.
Hello, fellas.
Mr. Smooth Groovy himself. River, how you doing?
I'm doing pretty good.
How's your gainful employment going?
You know, I learned this is what it's like to be an adult, and I got to provide for my family, so I'll do whatever it takes, you know?
Wait, who your family?
My three kids.
He's got three kids we don't even know about.
Oh, River.
River's crazy. He came, I picked him up today, and I says, "Oh, how was your day at work?" And he goes, "People." And I says, well, typically that's the problem with every job is the people. It's not the actual job.
You at the one up here?
Yeah, I don't know. I'll be here every single day this week except for Friday, so come visit me.
We didn't see you. We were there. Gabby and I were there with the kids.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I was there from 10 to 3 today. I don't know what time you guys came in.
And Justin, actually, I don't know if Michael's already told you about this, but Justin had a bad experience where they forgot half his order on Saturday.
Really?
And he was mad. Well, but it happens.
I didn't take his order.
Well,
so.
I mean, I told him surely it was not River's fault.
Yeah.
River would never.
No, it was probably River.
I worked there since December. Just kidding. Never got an order wrong.
Never in your life.
Never.
Oh, my word. But listen, guys, if you want to put in your shout outs now, River is over there trying to aggregate them as best he can. Be patient with him because he says, now, where did I write this down? And I was trying to explain to him how Reagan does it, so he's doing it right now.
River's
so
got this.
Rigor, he's absolutely got this. As a matter of fact, Reagan, you know, he might just be able to stay home after this, but anyway.
Who needs Chick-fil-A?
Who needs Chick-fil-A?
I need Chick-fil-A.
Right. You know, I mean, it's good to eat there. Careful. However, when you're behind the counter, it's a whole different story.
I'm sure it's a very different experience.
It really is.
Listen,
yeah.
If you're going to say something negative about Chick-fil-A, we're going to punch you in the face.
All right. Well, I don't have anything negative to say.
No, he doesn't.
You gain a lot of grace once you're behind the counter.
I bet you do.
Because once you see behind the scene.
I love the way you twisted that.
Right. Yeah.
I was looking for that word.
Is he going to be a pastor? Like, what was that?
He's been taught the art of the pulpit.
Yeah.
That's right. That's right.
Very good.
Let me show you how to polish this turd.
You did a great job.
He did. Well, guys, put your shout outs on now and we'll get to them. Listen, we're going to be giving $300 in free food away tonight. The way you do that is just share this YouTube stream right now. All you have to do is right click on the YouTube stream. It's going to pop up the URL address of this particular stream and put it on your social media and put it with the hashtag TW3Podcast353. And if you could put that in the chat so they got that hashtag TW3Podcast353.
You know, Terry, there is an easier way.
Well, tell them, please help me out.
If you're on YouTube, I'm on YouTube. If anybody's share. Wondering what I'm looking at, there's a button there.
There's a button.
It says simple.
Share.
I mean, even you can do it. I mean,
hey man,
I'm pushing it right now. It says share, and then you pick your Facebook, Twitter, Blogger, Reddit, Tumblr.
You can just
share it, but you will need to copy or type in the hashtag part.
That's, yes.
Yeah. So when you hit share,
hashtag means pound sign.
Thank you.
It's because our audience is not hashtag friendly.
Is it? Oh,
that
yeah.
is not true.
It's true.
Hashtag pound
sign. Is that why a lot of people in different generations during this Me Too movement was going around saying, what do they mean by pound Me Too?
Okay. Yes. Exactly.
Y'all always worry about me. It's not me that is the problem.
You're a hipster pastor, so you don't know. But the majority of people your age and up,
don't know what a hashtag is?
No, they don't.
So it's terrywilson3.com/...
No, it's TW3podcast353.
Oh, see, that's why you should do it. I was going to type it in here for you. So
TW3podcast353, hashtag, or pound, TW3.
Pound sign.
Whatever.
Wait. No, Mike Ramirez, he was at the conference. He told me that it means that, like, there's a term before pound, but it's this really long word, and I can't remember it right now. Does anybody know it?
I have no idea.
Well, that's why they made it pound. To make it a lot shorter.
River, you should Google it. I bet you know how to Google because you're hipster.
Right. I'm super hip.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like teleflora or epiphora or
word. Say you're making that up, I hope.
Now, Mike just typed in octothorpe.
Yes.
Now, what does that mean?
It means pound sign.
Oh, that's what it means?
Yeah,
that's the technical term for...
It's hashtag.
No.
What are we struggling with here?
No.
Listen, there are 380 million people in the United States, and there's nobody saying Ockathorpe.
Well, Ockathorpe. That's because they all died. Mike, an older term.
Well, Mike, glad to have you on here. This is your shout out, by the way.
Mike Ramirez is the man. Buff.
He apparently is, because if you know an Ockathorpe, no, it is hashtag.
Can't be
I'm not
Mike.
Even comfortable with pound sign. That's what happened in the 70s. You pushed a pound sign on your phone. Now, no, I wasn't even 70s.
Hold on, guys. This is what we're talking about when people get salty about us talking too much. So we need to move on.
Do people get salty about us?
I heard a couple of comments, yes.
What?
About how we shoot the breeze too much. So we need to
stay focused.
Shoot the breeze on and stay focused.
I'm going to have trouble with this.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so there's a bit of confusion. Is this just for the people at home, not, you know, here?
Not for River.
Not for River.
Now, you look confused. Is this 353 or 358? Because there's some confusion in the chat. Because somebody said, I thought this was 358.
This is 358. Thank you. Hashtag.
Way to go, Terry. Now everybody has to start over. So you're going to have to delete your share.
Can you tell? We've been gone for 2 weeks. You know, we weren't that good at this when we were practiced up.
And now we've been out of practice.
I'm telling you. But let's get into it. Questions, send them in, and we'll get to them right at the end. Real quick, if you want to hear pretty cool, I'm pretty proud of this one. I've pre-recorded some podcasts, guys. That's what I was doing last week, believe it or not.
I worked. Wow. Yeah. Okay.
After I woke up, you know, at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I worked and
I can vouch for that.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Running past your house, all the blinds closed, 1 p.m.
That's exactly. Don't let the sun in. But there's episode 359 is going to be published this Thursday, and I'm giving 10 pretty darn cool tips on how to up your conversion with using graphics. Different tips on using graphics and how to up your conversions, your opt-ins and stuff like that. That's going to be episode 359, but you have to be subscribed to the audio side of our podcast. And the way you do that is go over to terrywilson3.com/iTunes and subscribe either through iTunes, or if you use Stitcher, go over to stitcher.com, just type in Terry Wilson 3 and it'll pull that up and subscribe there, and you'll get the podcast there. Before we go into break, you know, we're talking tonight about fool's gold, what's real, what's not. And the reason I do this, guys, is not to brag. It's not to, you know, I was raised, it's sort of bad form to talk about income, but because the nature of this business is talking to people about entrepreneurialism and what they can do and how they can earn unlimited income by the tools we use here, I just feel like it's, you know, incumbent upon me to talk about, you know, what I'm doing and how I'm doing it, because that's the whole business model here. I show you exactly step by step what I'm doing to earn my money when you become a member, and based on your credential level is based on the level of tools you get, and the training you get, and the support you get. So that's the whole business in a box right there. And so, Lindsay, I sent you my income statements for March for this last quarter, and then last week with my RMP business. So if you could give the folks that real quick.
Yep. So the first number I have is $42,554.74, and that is, I believe, for March.
That's the month of March.
Okay. The quarter number I have is 107,656.34.
So $107,000 for the last 3 months or last quarter.
Yep.
$42,000 and some change for the month of March. And what did I do last week just in RMP business? That's the referral marketing business.
Well, number one, you were up 33.3%, which is fantastic.
Well, that was because I wasn't doing a lot of this. I got to concentrate on my RMP business more. So that helps a little.
You were at 14,749.
14,000 last week.
Yeah.
In just referral marketing business. And referral marketing is how, that's what we call all of our affiliate marketing, CPA marketing, and all of that stuff combined, where I get paid to give books away, where I get paid to generate leads for insurance companies, real estate companies, those types of things. So that's what that is involved with right there. So that is that. And so when we get back from the commercial break, we're going to be talking about your shout outs. We're going to be talking about how you can discern what's real and what's not when you're pursuing a particular opportunity and some things that I use. And we're going to even talk to Lindsay and Chris about, you know, we've all had buyer's remorse at some point. You know, you thought something was going to be one way, and then when you got into it, you know, it wasn't what you expected.
So. I'm so excited for this segment. It just happened this weekend. Y'all ain't ready.
Gosh, you're
prepping us.
You're scaring me already. So we'll be back right after this.
You know, if you've ever listened to my podcast, you've heard me say it 1,000 times. Earners are learners and leaders are readers. If you want to go to the next level, you do have to grow to the next level. And growth happens by the people you hang around and listen to the most. Seth Godin says you're the sum total of 5 people you hang around the most. And that is why you need to go to terrywilson3.com/freebook and get a free audiobook just to try out the services. Here's the deal. Over 70,000 different authors from every type of genre that you could think of. Go over there, pick one that you like, something that's going to inform you, something that's going to inspire you, something that's going to illustrate what you need to do next. Try out the service. If you don't like the service, cancel it and you get to keep that free audiobook. But you're going to love the service. And I promise you, if you will commit yourself to listening and learning from those who have gone where you want to go, you can go there also. So go to terrywilson3.com/freebook today. Try out the service and get a free audiobook just for trying it out. terrywilson3.com/freebook.
So how would you like to put your income on autopilot? You know, you've heard several online marketing gurus say the loot is in the list. And it is true. Email marketing done correctly will amass you thousands, if not millions of dollars. Part of my affiliate CPA and referral marketing business that I do, that I bring in thousands of dollars a week, is done by email marketing. But if you're just starting out, which systems do you use? What script do you use? How do you even get emails? All of those things make it tough when you're first getting started. So go over to terrywilson3.com/MDEMS. I wrote an ebook called The $1 Million Email Marketing System. And it's a book and it's also video formulas and things there that's going to illustrate exactly what to use, how to use it, where to go to get certain emails that you need, how to present those emails when you send them out. Everything you need to do to start your own email marketing business and bringing that in as part of your strategy on how to make money, you can get by going to terrywilson3.com/MDEMS. That's terrywilson3.com/MDEMS.
And now back to our show with Terry Wilson.
Yakety yak, we are back. So thank you guys so far for sharing. Chris, we got a lot of people sharing already.
Yes, we do.
Very, very cool.
Yes, we do. It's rolling.
So make sure you're putting in that hashtag so we can find you, because someone is going to win $300 in free food tonight. And we want to give it away because God knows I don't need to eat anymore.
Hey, you need to get on that macro life with us. It's but good.
I don't know if I could do it, because isn't macros full of like carbs?
No, with macros, the nutrition...
I like macro and cheese. Is it
No. The nutrition coach I'm working with has me at 33 for fat, carb, protein.
Oh, okay.
So you just eat balanced.
Just eat balanced.
Justin is struggling because he likes a lot of sausage and cheese, and that's just not part of my life.
Most guys like meat and cheese and stuff like that. So I need to do that, absolutely. So, guys, let me ask you a question. Has anyone out there in the live studio audience tonight on the live stream, has anyone ever, had something or someone in your mind up on a pedestal, and then when you met them or you experienced that product, good or service, or that person, that after meeting that person or after grabbing a hold of whatever it was that you had, this is valuable, you got it, and then all of a sudden it became less valuable. Mm-hmm. Lindsay, I'll start with you. Have you ever had that experience?
It happened this weekend.
What happened?
So we've been out of hand soap at our house for a couple weeks, and I was kind of holding off because a couple months ago I went to Costco and I found these glass bottles, amber glass, which is great, way, way better than plastic for your body and for your health. These glass bottles with essential oil infused hand soap.
Okay.
So it's good stuff, right?
Right.
And so I was like, okay, I could Amazon it, but I'm going to hold out. I'm going to stay strong until we go back to Costco.
Right.
So we go to Costco on Saturday, and they had the most beautiful hand soap. And it was a 4-pack of hand soap with this beautiful, it looked like hand-painted pottery. And I know that it looked like hand-painted pottery because once upon a time I had a boyfriend. His name was Miguel, and his mom painted amazing pottery. They lived in Mexico and he was over here for work. And his mom painted. So I know what hand-painted pottery looks like.
Right, right.
I know. It was stunning. And so I get to the checkout because I had actually forgotten it. And we got in the checkout line. I said, oh, I forgot hand soap. And I ran back and got it. And I bring it to the checkout and Justin goes, is that $40 worth of hand soap? And I said, it's not, but if it was, I'd still pay it because this is good stuff. Like, I was pumped about this purchase. I was invested.
Right.
And so then on Saturday night, Callie and Jess were over at our house having dinner. And I,
my invitation must have got lost.
Listen, don't even get me started.
Saturday I was asking people if they wanted to come over and eat, and I couldn't get a hold of anybody.
Nobody
would come over and eat. And so then I found out.
I have to tell you, I was super duper conflicted about that because I even said to both of them, I said, I really want to invite the Wilsons, but if there are three families here, I'm going to drown in my introverted stress.
Well, yeah, it's a choice. You had to choose between us and others, and you made your choice. That's fine. Right?
Yeah, this isn't getting better.
Hold on.
You might want to finish with your soap.
Go ahead and start your soap story.
I'll tell you the rest later about that. Anyway.
Callie, do you need some leads? Sorry.
I'll take some leads.
So Callie and Jess were there, and one of them went to the bathroom, and I was like, is the hand soap low? And they were like, yeah, it's low. And I said, I got it. And I opened up my brand new bottles, my 4 bottles, and I said, I've got these, and they're from Costco, and it was $9.99. Can you believe what a deal I got on these? These are amazing. And I had to get out the scissors to open the thing.
Right.
Do you know it was plastic bottles? I was absolutely heart crushing all the ways. And
Justin's over here just laughing.
Thought it was hilarious. Yeah, and I was completely, completely devastated because they were not hand-painted pottery. They weren't even pottery.
Oh, my word. It happens. That's a classic buyer's remorse.
And I even told my friends, y'all, look at this. It's going to be good. And they were like, it ain't good, Lindsay.
Chris,
I've been alive a long time, and
you never put hand soap up on a pedestal. Huh? I was thinking the same thing.
I've never had this conversation before. I don't know if I've ever been around anybody that is as animated and excited about hand soap.
It had essential oils in it.
I don't care what it is.
I don't care.
It could have crack cocaine in it. All
I'm trying my best to say, yeah, that's awesome. Yeah. You getting
your
really?
Heart broke over hand soap. You had essential oils in your hand soap.
I thought I had robbed the bank for 4 hand-painted pottery bottles of soap with essential oils in it.
Now, if I would have opened it up, it would have had gold in it or something. Maybe
that's
I would
the
get
same
excited.
Level for me. Essential oils are gold.
My story is going to be a big right turn from the old no,
please go ahead and take the turn.
It's not going to be soap. So my big disappointment.
Yeah, top that, Jack.
I can't. I don't even know. I wouldn't even know where to begin. So, a little unknown fact about myself, and it's a big unknown fact amongst the majority of the population. But I was actually in the movie The Patriot.
Yes, I remember that. Yeah.
Yep, back in the early days with that. Mel Gibson.
Family facts over here.
Family facts. Yes.
So, what happened was? I got cast to be one of the soldiers. There's about 100 of us total that went through this training for about 3 weeks. Oh. So we go through our training, learning to shoot the musket rifles. I mean, there was Heath Ledger was out there hanging out. Jason Isaacs, they were all having to learn to do it too. Now, I'm going to be honest. We were on one side of the field. They were on the other.
The privileged side.
We were not together.
We were together, but not together. They had a class system, I'm sure.
Oh, it was a class system. You know, you don't cross over into this class. Yeah. So we're all learning to march, everything about Revolutionary War type stuff. And so that goes on for weeks. And then they start loading us up on these horse trailer things and taking you to different shoot locations around where we were. And so we go out, I'm filming big scenes. So one of the big scenes I'm in is, and I was in several, but this one is my moment when I figured out what I was going to do. The kid, and if you haven't seen it by now, you're probably not going to. So I'm going to tell you a big moment in one of Mel Gibson's sons gets killed. It's that scene at the house. You've not seen this movie?
I don't like death and destruction.
Oh, but this is war. This is history.
Justin has seen it.
Yeah.
So this big scene, it's at the house, end up burning the house down. I mean, and we spent days at this place, and they have a way that they can burn the house and then stop it, burn it, stop it, burn it, stop it.
Whoa.
They built these slave houses, all this stuff. It was incredible what they did. So I say all that to say this. So this is my moment. Big scene. Cameras. They had special cameras that day. They had this big thing where all of the dragoons had rode up on the horses, and this event happens, and they ride off into this big camera shot.
Mm-hmm.
So that day, or that during that whole set, I was selected as one of the wounded. And so they put blood on my face and stuff. And then you're with this little carriage thing. And so I took my hat off, you know, acted like I was super wounded. And while we began to march out, I backed away from the carriage about 10 feet. Now, why is that important? Because when this goes to the movies, I'm going to be able to say, that's me. There's the carriage, all the injured people, me.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So I set this whole thing up. They didn't stop me. Nobody corrected me. I'm like, this is going well. And so it happens. And now there's other good ones, but that was my big one. So the big movie comes out, take all my family, movie theaters packed. I mean, literally packed, all my family, all my friends, and we go to watch. And I'm not in that movie. There's no. There's not a moment. You know, they would do this thing where they would take the camera with a bunch of soldiers, and they would pan down the line. So if you remember in the movie, there are several times when they'll show faces of soldiers and all that. I'm not one of those. I was not picked to be one of those people.
There's a scene where
you remember when the little ball goes. You didn't see it, Terry. The ball goes down and knocks the guy's head off.
Yes.
I was in that scene. But I'm not in that scene.
Your poor wife.
I'm in it, but like, I'm not in it.
Seeing your disappointment in your
face. It was pretty devastating.
I'm sure she was.
My entire family's going, Chris, I'm not sure I saw you up on the screen. Were you really in that movie?
We all went to the movies to see Uncle Chris.
Aww.
Cousin Chris. Brother-in-law Chris.
And he wasn't there.
No.
I bought the DVD, watched all the behind scenes. I'm not on it. I went frame by frame. I am not in it. Now, I probably am in it. I know I am, but you can't tell which one I am. When they would do the big shots of the soldiers shooting each other and stuff, I'm in that.
Right.
Mm.
But you didn't see me. You didn't see me. Now, I made a decision about this whole thing, by the way.
Okay.
Mel Gibson, Jason Isaacs, and Heath Ledger, they saw me and said, he can't be in the movie. That guy looks better than we do. So,
because he would take all the fame.
Yes, he would take
all
the fame.
That's a good one, Chris. That was a good one.
So now here's the thing about the story, what my disappointment was. I met Mel Gibson. Yeah. I mean, he's there. He comes up every shot. You know, he has a body double who does most of the practicing part when we're running through it, prepping.
Right.
And then he walks up, and he's a weird dude. He was probably the biggest disappointment of anybody you'd ever meet. He is more than an artist. Now, I'm not throwing his talent out, because I will say the dude would come up, he's goofy, and he makes weird faces, and he's showing off constantly. He'd like get an axe and throw it. He wouldn't like approach you one-on-one, and you're not certainly not allowed to approach him. You'd be taken off. Mm-hmm. He would just constantly show off, and do all this stuff, and he'd be goofy walking. He's a chain smoker. He's smoking all the time, and then he'd walk up, but it was amazing because he didn't say, okay, quiet on the set. We're ready. Everybody in place. And right at that moment, his whole face and demeanor would change instantly, and he'd become this person. So unbelievably talented, but he's a weirdo.
I mean, but here's the thing. Some people are introverts.
He's not an introvert. He's a weirdo.
Are you sure?
Yeah, he's the kind of guy that you don't want to be around.
Maybe all those people freaked him out and made him not act like himself.
Jason Isaacs. He was also kind of chill. Nicest guy you'll ever meet.
All right.
He'd come up to you. You could talk to him. He never got weird about it. He was cool. Heath Ledger, never saw him. Other than far, far off. He was super famous at that time. Mm-hmm. And they would just bring him in. He'd do his thing and they'd escort him away.
Yeah.
So he never hung out. He wasn't hanging out. The body double, who did look a little bit like Mel Gibson, he was amazing. Hilarious. Great guy. Goofed off with all of us.
Probably humble and could approach.
Very much so. Oh, he hung out with us the whole time. I mean, just sit there and shoot the breeze with us, whatever.
I had a similar experience when we went to a homeschool conference up in Winston-Salem, and they had this national, if I mention his name, everybody that's in the evangelical circles would know. So I'm not going to mention his name.
Till commercial.
No, well, yeah, I'll tell you during commercial.
Or ask me one-on-one.
But, you know, I've been around enough to know you respect people's boundaries. You don't hit on them, you know, especially at conferences. Give them space because they're speaking, you know, those kinds of things. You give people space. But the conference was over. Everything had subsided. All I did was I said, this is my name. I represent a community of churches. We're willing. We've got a budget up to $20,000 to do an event in a community. We'd love to talk to you or your people or something sometimes. If it's, you would have thought I had three eyes. And I mean, the guy was, for lack of a better term, just a butthole. Mm. An absolute butthole. And so I said, well, he's having a bad day. I tell you what, maybe it was me. Maybe I hit him wrong. So I had someone else in our organization approach later, someone else, same thing. And they came back, and I didn't lead the witness. I didn't expect it. I didn't say anything. I just said, I wasn't able to make a connection with him. Why don't you go sometime? And they had the same response. And so I'm like, you know, it was like, womp, womp, womp.
Yeah.
So, you know, sometimes we put people, things, opportunities up on a pedestal.
Soap.
I think you're supposed to put soap on a pedestal, Lord.
Listen, that was going to be some good soap.
But sometimes, you know, it's disappointing. And so, and here's the thing. Sometimes it's not the thing or the person, it's us. Because sometimes we weren't listening to what they were trying to communicate.
Yeah.
And we projected what we wanted the thing to be, and it wasn't. And then we're frustrated.
Oh, right on the package. When I threw the package away, it said plastic.
Yeah.
I didn't read that.
So. Yeah, that was all me. Time to read.
That brings us to our
Stuck on Stupid.
You can't fix stupid.
This always makes me nervous.
So I bring this one up just because I don't want to. This has nothing to do with picking at anyone or hurting anyone. I'm not even going to mention the person's name or anything. But, you know, here's a person that probably feels like they got involved with TW3 and it was fool's gold, okay? Because their perspective was, I tried something, it didn't work, and it's their fault, okay? So I get that. And guys, the only reason I bring this up is because I think it's a teachable moment, because this is a real opportunity. Guys, we've had, since the conference, which, by the way, if you're not coming to the conference, you've got to register for that. And we're going to be introducing links to be able to do that in the coming weeks. We haven't got them fully done yet, but we've already, when's the date? Does March 19th through the 21st, I believe.
Yes.
Of next year. Tickets went on sale at the conference. They're not on sale yet for the general populace, but I'll go ahead and let the cat out of the bag. It's $147. And anybody was at that conference, I pretty much believe they'll tell you that it was well worth it. As a matter of fact, since the conference, we've had 1 week pass since the conference. Last week we were off, And since that conference, we've had 5 people make their first sales.
All right, that's all awesome.
You know, 5 people. Some of them.
Shout out to Ayan.
Ayan, you are a rock star. Did you meet? Yeah, we met Ayan.
Oh, I totally hung out with her. She's my favorite. I'm jealous that she's not under me. That I don't get to talk to her every week for coaching calls.
I know.
So you keep saying she.
She. Because I kept saying dude.
What does that mean?
Well, before I met her, I kept saying brother.
Terry.
You know, and I'm looking at the name. I don't know how you come up with brother or he. I mean, it is definitely her name.
Because I'm illiterate, Chris.
Good old South Carolina.
What do you call it? I forgot the name. Pat is, you know, what's.
Yeah, it's gender neutral.
Gender neutral.
Yeah.
Oh, did you guys see that on Grey's Anatomy last week?
No,
I didn't. No, you're chasing a rabbit. Let's get on this.
Okay. No, we don't watch.
Here's the thing. I got this review. I want to break it down because I had 3 or 4 members already ask me about it. And so I want to bring it up just for teaching purposes so that you know how to communicate to your clients. And if you're a client out there on with someone, so you hear it straight from the horse's mouth. You don't have to wonder, well, what does Terry think about this? I had a review that came in. It says, it's a job selling the same job you do. Okay. And his opening line is basically you pay money to start the job selling the job you paid money to do. That's pretty much it. Now, what breaks my heart, number one, is this person didn't take the time to go through the training. They were actually a plus member. And I can tell you empirically, because I had conversations with them, I saw tickets with them. Their second day in the business, they were ready to quit because they demanded a one-on-one with me to explain how I did something in a video where I was illustrating what I made doing referral marketing. And so trying to dash, you know, water on this fire and get this person under wraps. I tried to help my rep out who sold it to him. And I said, listen, what you need to do, I just sent him out an email. I can't meet with you one-on-one. I don't have time, but here's what I can tell you to do. You need to go through steps 1 through 6. You need to learn how to set up your blog. You need to know how to set up a sales funnel. You need to have how to set up opt-in forms and things of that nature. And then go to step 7 and look at the double dip and capture strategy I show. That's got a lot to do with the way I do a lot of my business. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I sent them out an email and then they started sending me messages through LinkedIn and I had to disconnect from them from LinkedIn because I was getting hounded. I mean, blown up my inbox.
Yeah.
And I said, listen, I'm going to disconnect here. You need to send tickets in to ticket support. You need to ask for training from your trainer. That's not what I do here. And then he's sitting in, mm-hmm. I want my money back because Terry, and well, I don't do that. I don't have time. And so it was already on a rocky start, this person that left this. I just wanted people to understand the context. He says, you'll learn some website design stuff or you'll have to pay others to do it for you. True. I don't know why that's a negative response, but it is. And how to build a sales funnel, or you'll have to pay someone to do it for you. There's a lot of talk during web chat meetings of selling all kinds of things you'll probably never learn to sell. To be honest, it's way more like an MLM than Terry is willing to admit. It's not exactly a pyramid, but like MLMs, you make money by getting new sellers to sign on. You can't really make money any other way. Now, I think I saw Chris on here, Christopher. That was on here. Chris, if you're on, go ahead and tell the people in the live chat. Chris, I don't know if you've made your first sale yet or not, but Chris came on. And as a matter of fact, I'm going to have a video.
Yes. Christopher Miller.
Christopher Miller. And I forget how many thousands of dollars he made just in the first few weeks, not reselling TW3.
But using
TW3. Yeah. And what people don't understand
now
is.
You're way underselling that. I don't know if Chris will say it, but I mean, wasn't it like
34?
Wait a minute. No, but I just made 7,000 last week. That's what he just wrote.
Yeah.
The best thing I heard at the conference, I took this home. In my session, someone was saying that they had used their tools for their other business.
Yeah.
And it had grown so much that they had to quit using our tools because they could not manage the business incoming.
So this is just nonsense. And here's the thing, guys. I want you to understand this. I'm not beating up on this person. I don't really, you know, I feel bad just because they can't get out of their own way. Because I don't mind a negative review. I don't mind them saying, you know, I tried Terry's system. It was complicated for me, so I just quit. I didn't like it. That's honest.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And that's what happened. It's clearly just, even from his own statements, he said several things that shows he just never took the time to learn it. And I think it's completely fair to say that there are some people who will struggle if they're not able to discipline themselves to get in front of the computer, to watch videos, take notes, maybe have a notepad, make notes and learn as you go.
Right.
Because there, it's trainings. A little bit of laziness. I want it right now. I want the money. No, it's
just all by the second day. He was wanting to know how to make that $30,000 I was showing on RMP while I was on a cruise. And if he didn't get it.
Well, how many years have you been doing this?
I've been doing a few years.
Yeah, so that 30,000 took 10 or 11
and
years.
And I never represented that you're going
to
be able to do RMP. I do represent that if you'll get in, start doing steps 1 through 6 and learning that, you know, it's sort of like how Miyagi taught Daniel karate. You're doing paint the fence. You're doing wax on, wax off. You're doing a bunch of stuff that doesn't make sense. Yeah, Chris just said, all told, I've made $34,000 just to having the info learned here in my own business, never having sold TW3.
Wow.
I mean, guys, I'm not making this up. This is a gentleman that you can connect with on here if you don't believe me. This is not my words. These are his words. But I want to read this one thing because I think this is the telltale right here, and I want to get your guys' response. Then we're going to move on. I want to talk to you about how you can make sure that you don't ever, ever, ever get stung by fool's gold, because it can happen, and I don't want any of my members and listeners to do that. So here he goes. He says, you can make money as it by selling the same job you do to other people, but most job seekers don't seem to be interested in paying to work. Plus, there's lots of other little costs that those resorting to this probably don't want to pay. And I'm trying to find where he said something. I just thought it was, here he goes. In my month with TW3, I made no sales while taking hundreds of phone calls. And I only got one sales rep and trainer onboarded, which was a free service. And he was frustrated because he wasn't getting the training he needed. Now, what's wrong with that sentence right there?
You made $750.
Well, he didn't.
He had a free person.
He had a free affiliate.
Oh, an affiliate. Okay.
So the first thing he says, I want to break it down. I took hundreds of calls. The system worked. What we just gave him, the marketing system, the strategies of how to start driving inbound by his own admission, worked.
Yes, he had hundreds of calls, which means he wasn't able to close any of those. But I'd also say it depends on how he was doing it. So if he was doing where they were calling him, well, that percentage goes way down who's going to convert, because those are cold calls.
He wasn't setting up his funnel the way he was
talking. That's right. You didn't get the warm calls, and then he didn't close it, which is
Then he got one affiliate, and the affiliate complained the whole time because of the support and training he was getting.
Which is his job.
Because he's the trainer. That's why we call him. So he leaves me a 1-star review because my system did exactly what it said it would do, get you in front of unlimited amount of leads.
Yeah, he proved his point. Yeah, I talked to hundreds. And he also noticed he said the 1 month I was there. I have said this over and over to the folks I talked to. You need to think 4 to 6 weeks.
At a minimum.
Yeah. And that's, you know, if everything goes right, learning it, setting it up. Plus, you're learning to sell. You're learning to sell the products. And sometimes you have to talk to a lot more people to get better at it. Hey, thank you for the 1-star review that just went and validated everything that we say that's going on here.
Well, and not to get too personal, but we've out of the 10 going on 11 years, we're in July, it'll be 11 years with TW3. We've had a little over 55, 56 positive reviews. And now we've got 5 with his negative reviews. And they all come from the same place. I tried it. It didn't work for me. And they won't give me my money back. And I'm telling you up front right now, as you're hearing me, hear me now or feel me later, as I like to say, what you're getting is a digital product. It's a website. There's hosting, there's software, and there's plugins, there's training by your trainers. All of these are intangible products that can't be returned. Therefore, there are no refunds. So if you don't want to do this or you're not committed to doing it, don't do it. Because here's the other thing, that if he would have taken the training, one of the things where he was saying his opening sentence said you have to sell the system to make money with the system. He could have been giving people that he claimed wouldn't buy anything. He could have given them hourly jobs and gotten paid for it. He was a plus member.
He didn't set up his links.
He didn't set up anything. Yeah. So if you don't work the system will not work. So that is our
Stuck on Stupid.
You can't fix stupid.
And so, you know, what do you do? But guys, when we get back right after this, We're going to be talking about ways that I discern and look at opportunities, because as you become an entrepreneur out there and you start looking at things that you want to do, you need to really look at it with a sharp eye, you know, and discern, is this really what I want to do? Is there a way to make money with this? And so I'm going to sort of give you some of my filters that I use to sort of qualify the opportunities I go after, because once you have your system at TW3 set up, man, you've got opportunities galore, but not all opportunities are good. We'll be back right after this.
Have you ever tried a work from home business? If you have, you may be like several others. Matter of fact, 98% of people, according to Forbes magazine, who've tried and failed. Why? Well, there's several reasons, but the main reason is because most home-based businesses have no means, method, or mechanism for you to get in front of people who need, want, desire, and can afford what it is you offer. See, the unique thing about TerryWilson3.com is we put you in a position where if you can simply answer a phone, read a script, you can make money. And I'm not talking about going and selling pills, thrills, lotions, and potions. I'm talking about selling something that every business, everyone who has a product, good, or service needs. And that is a lead generation marketing system. But here's the cool thing. You never cold call. You never have to recruit your friends, family, and foes. You simply take a call, read a script. Want more information? Go to TerryWilson3.com/call center right now to get more information. That's TerryWilson3.com/call center.
Hey, do you need cash for business expenses or bill consolidation, inventory, or maybe reinvesting in your business? You know, when money is tight, man, I tell you, business can be stressful. Trust me, I know. So I want to tell you, learn how to leverage money and time with a great product and service that I use all the time at TW3. It's a custom financing opportunity that the terms and the services are totally custom fit for you. It's easy, it's fast, it's secure, and it's at cashmutualstore.com. That's cashmutualstore.com. So what are you waiting for? Do you need inventory, or do you need to reinvest in your business? Do you need to start a business? You can grow your business by leveraging easy lending opportunity at cashmutualstore.com. Join the thousands of other entrepreneurs and small businesses we've helped at cashmutualstore.com so you can start taking your income, your business, and your life to the next level. That's cashmutualstore.com. Easy, fast, and secure.
And now back to our show with Terry Wilson.
Okay. Yes, yes, yes. So how do you keep from getting burnt? You know, and that's the sad thing. So many people... what irritates me more about that comment that the gentleman's making, other than it's just not factual, is, isn't it just like people, Chris, you and I know someone intimately, and I'm not going to bring up, but this gentleman that we know through high school stunk in sports, was terrible at athletics, had a son, and refused to allow his son to go play sports for years and years, and finally got into high school, and he begrudgingly let him go run track. And it was through running track that he was won a scholarship to be able to go to a college.
Right.
And, you know, and isn't that just human nature sometimes, that people that have tried and failed, they try to project that on other people. And that's what's so frustrating, because there's going to be someone that reads that review that maybe not with us, but they won't even bet on themselves when it's a legitimate opportunity for them to, it's the thing that they're praying about, right? God, give me something I can do to better my life. And now they're going to be talked out of it because of some cynic that's not even representing the facts correctly.
Right.
That's what's frustrating about it to me. And it just,
yes,
it's aggravating, but what do you do? What do you do? What do you do? So if you are in the place where you're wanting to do more in your personal or professional life, how can you discern from good opportunities and those that are just not so good opportunities? Here's some ways that I weed out the opportunities I pursue from the ones I pass on. And I do pass on. I get hit up all the time with people. Hey, Terry, try this. Sell this pill. Because, you know, once you're in the opportunity space and people figure out you're a marketer, they all of a sudden want you, you know, selling their stuff and promoting their stuff. And so as you guys, especially you TW3 members that have this platform and can generate unlimited leads whenever you want and have them qualified and the whole process is automated, you're going to have more and more opportunities. So how do you weed the ones that you want to do and the ones that you don't need to do out so that you're not wasting your time? And so that's what we're talking about. So my first criteria, guys, is I ask a simple question. Are other people having success with it? I think that's just a great question. You need to go behind me, go behind Lindsay and Chris, go behind and just find out, are other people having success? One of the great things about this particular opportunity versus other opportunities you can find online is we've been out there now going on 11 years, and it's not just me making money. It's a ton of people. And it's new people every day. I know we've got members that have been with me for years. I think Greenbacks is on the night, and I think he closed a couple elite sales today. But beyond him, there are other people that, you know, Quackenbush has been on with us for a long time, making tons and tons of money. Bam Bam's making tons and tons of money. And then the argument goes, well, Terry, these guys, they're rock stars. What about the new? We've had five people from the conference that just came back already making their first sales. And you don't necessarily have to go to the conference to make it, but it's sort of like a shot in the arm. It gives you a bolt of lightning to get you going quick. And we're seeing results. We're seeing new people come on every single day with TW3 and making money, making great money, making good money. And so the opportunity is real. So if you ask yourself a question, are other people having success? If you're considering the TW3 opportunity, then absolutely yes. Well, then number two, a subset of that, if they are having opportunity, and here's a question I want to drill down a little deeper. Of those that are having success with this, am I similar to them? And what I mean by that, you might say, well, I'm not this rock star salesperson like so-and-so. Well, I could introduce you to people in this business right now that hardly ever talk to people. Lindsay.
I was waiting for it.
Well, I don't want to pick on you, but I'm going to pick on you.
That's okay. I'm ready.
I don't consider you this hard, ramped up, got to close them, snag them and bag them type of person.
No, I'm not at all.
Matter of fact, you're probably, you're more in the vein, are you sure you want to do this?
No,
She's talking him out of it. Yeah. No, seriously.
I love TW3 I love the product and I think it's amazing, but I am very much aware of a person when I speak to them. Like if I feel like that they don't necessarily need to be borrowing this money.
Right.
I mean, I'll even use the phrase, you can check this out if you want to and see if this makes sense for your budget.
Right.
And see if this makes sense for your finances. And, you know, I will give them all the resources and I will answer all the questions, but I am not going to talk you into a biz op that you don't need.
And the reason you need to do that and why it's so smart is because on the back end of this, they need to own the decision.
Mm-hmm.
It don't need to be, but you know, and I'm not criticizing because we've got people in our business that are just great, great salespeople. I mean, they can sell ice to someone and
I'm not one of them.
But you're not one of them. You find tremendous. So my point is when you're asking the question, are other people finding success? Yes. Well, the people that are finding success, are you similar? Well, if you're out there and you're saying, well, Terry, I'm just not great at sales. Let me point you to Lindsay Taylor.
I'm not great at sales. I'm really not, because I'm not a hard sell. I don't want to convince you to do something that you don't want to do. Now, if you want to do it, I'll give you all your options and I will support you and I will coach you till the cows come home.
Right.
But I do not want to convince you to do something you don't want to do.
And then all of those people are having success. Am I similar? Maybe you're like Lindsay. I can't, you know, Terry, I'm just not that great at sales. And then we go down of those who are having success. How am I different from them? Well, Lindsay here is a mom. She's got a lot of irons in the fire. TW3 is not the only business that she runs. Mm-hmm. It's one of them, but it's not the only.
I think that's another important thing too. Like I need to speak to that.
Yeah.
Is my husband is very successful in his career.
Right.
And so his income takes care of us well.
Right.
And so I am not over here like
stressing,
freaking out.
Right.
Like if I can sell a system to someone that is coachable and teachable, that is what I'm passionate about. I would love to coach you. I would love to see you realize your dreams and I would love to see you be incredibly successful.
Right.
But it's you deciding to buy a TW3 system is not putting groceries on my table.
Right.
So
and now, but that right there is really why you're successful.
Right.
Because it's so attractive when you, because you feel like the person's really being honest when they can walk away from it and say, you know what, on second thought, you know, then all of a sudden it's a psychological thing. Wait a minute. They call it the takeaway. Mm-hmm. In sales, but you're not doing it on purpose. It's not a technique. It's your it's your reality. You're yeah. like, here it is, but you know, it might not be. And you have this posture about you that, you know, take it or leave it. I don't, you know, it doesn't.
Right.
And because of that,
and it's not that I don't care.
I know you. Like, it's not, it's not a matter of care.
Like, if you decide to come onto my team,
right?
I am going to take care of you. I'm going to coach you well. But again, I'm not going to talk you into something that you don't want to do.
Well, because you're going to position yourself that they own the decision.
Right.
You're just not going to allow them to put the decision making on you. Mm-mm. So that they can blame you later.
We're not doing that.
Which is smart, which is very smart. So if you're out there and you say, I'm just not a rock star salesman, Lindsay. Mm-hmm. And you're saying, but wait a minute, I've got time during the day. Listen, guys, she only works an hour and a half a day with TW3.
Or less the last couple of weeks.
And really less. Yeah. And she's knocking down good money. Mm-hmm. So if you're out there, how are you different? You might have 3 or 4 hours a day where she only has an hour or so a day.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there's a distinction that's actually to your advantage. So number one, I ask myself, are other people having success with this opportunity? That's how I always look at it. Number two, has the opportunity been proven? What you can see by our live chat right now, people are talking, and I know we've got tons of reps on here tonight. They're talking about what they've made. Chris, we've talked about him using
the system. I noticed one I wanted to bring up.
Sure, go right ahead.
Because it's a name I'm not familiar with. I'm sure you are. Trevor Eisenman.
Yeah, we know Trevor.
Since January 30th?
Yes.
Over $6,000.
See?
And he's out here. You can scroll up if you're on here and see for yourself. And he's right there.
He's right there. He's making money. Mm-hmm. He's using the system. He's making money with the system. So guys.
And he's new to the business.
He's not one of my guys that's been with me forever that everybody, oh, you're always talking about so-and-so and such, but it's not fair because they've been with you for 5 or 6 years. Right. Well, here we've mentioned people tonight that have just started with us that are making money. Mm-hmm. And the only reason I bring up the people that have been with me forever is because I want you to know this is where you're headed. If you stay on this path, this is where you can be. And I'm not going to mention names because it's not about the names, but I want to tell you something, guys. Some of my top reps have noticeable deficiencies. Some of them have great sales acumen, but bad technical acumen.
Yeah.
Some of them have wildly high proficiency with technical stuff, but have some really weaknesses in their relatability, communication, and sales mm-hmm. ability. Some of them, and I'm not going to mention names because it doesn't matter. It's not. I have reps that are knocking down 25 to 4 grand a week that came up to me in a private moment and told me about some things I did not even know was going on in their life. And I was like, my God, how are you making what you're making with all of those distractions and all those things that's going on in your life? But they're doing it. Mm-hmm. So I'm telling you guys, if your desire is bigger than the resistance that's in front of you, the sky is the limit. I've got people that have been with me for a little under a year now that have reading disabilities that I didn't know about. So Terry, the reason why I struggle, I'm just going to be straight up. I have this reading disability. I've got dyslexia and I got this issue and I got mm-hmm. this issue. And it just didn't come easy to me. And these people are making a couple grand a week now.
Wow.
Because they stuck with it, they went through it, and it made it happen. So I don't care who you are out there tonight, either on with us live, listening to us later, there's someone I can point to in this business that's going to be just like you that are finding success. How long has that opportunity been around? Is it a flash in the pan? Well, this has been here 11 years. And the third thing, I always run opportunities that are coming to me to see if it's something that I want to pursue or if it possibly could be fool's gold, is do I understand the cost versus the price I am considering? Many people are not able to delineate the difference between price and cost. The price is what you pay for something. Mm-hmm. The cost is what you pay and also the loss of opportunity. I have a saying that says there's a high cost for low living. What I mean by that is there are some people that are on here tonight that you do not need to do entrepreneurialism. You need to go get an hourly job, and we're going to be able to give that to you if you want it. We've got opportunities. We can send you over to get hourly jobs. There are other people on here tonight. You have a proficiency with just basic skills that are required to be able to be successful, and you can be successful, but you'll talk yourself out of it because of fear. You'll talk yourself out of it because of past failures. You'll talk yourself out of it. And I'm telling you, you can go and pay a low price and go get it. We can get you an hourly or salary job or something like that. There's no cost to it at all. I mean, there's no price. You don't pay anything. But man, there's a high cost to it. I mean, you're only making $10, $15 an hour when you could pay the price of $3,000 maybe on one of our top packages. But the cost of that is going to be way much lower for you later on, because you're going to make thousands of dollars in return because you have what it takes.
And it's a tax write-off.
Exactly. So don't talk yourself out of greatness when the very thing that you need could be right in front of you. But here again, guys, you know, it's got to be right for you. And so in this business, I would tell you, you need to be able to have some basic, I'm not saying you have to be a super marketing guru, but you just have to have some basic understanding of sales. Basic. You've got to be able to turn on a computer. You got to be able to email. You got to be able to respond to email. We've had people come on and they get frustrated. Well, how did you, I said it was sent in your email. They don't even know how to check their email. Okay. We can't help that. Because we don't teach computers at TW3.
Yeah.
We teach our system and our software. So you got to come with a certain amount of proficiency there. But you don't have to be some sort of, you know, developer or anything like that. So we're going to be back right after this, and we're going to get in and answer your questions. So if you've got questions and we have not talked to you about it yet, make sure you get them in now. Have you got some questions, River, that you've got already loaded up for the people? Did I wake you up? I think I just woke you up. But we'll get back right after this. We'll answer your questions, and then we'll get out of here. I hope you guys are enjoying this. We are. But questions. And then we're going to give $300 in food away. So, Chris, you go over and find out who's been sharing this.
They have been selected.
We are going to give some food away right after this. So there's two things that I use on a daily basis to make more money, make more sales. Because I have learned over 20 some odd years of being an entrepreneur is most people do not make a significant purchase the first time they hear about it, or even the second time. As a matter of fact, it normally takes six encounters with a client before they will ever decide to pull the trigger on anything. How do you scale a business if you can't automate that process? One of the things and tools that I use is AWeber, which is an automatic email marketing system. Right now, you can get a 30-day free trial by going to terrywilson3.com/AWeber. That's terrywilson3.com/AWeber, AWeber, and try their services out. I think you're going to really like it. And if you decide to keep it after 30 days, they'll give you a discount for using that code. Go to terrywilson3.com/AWeber right now and put your marketing and your sales process on autopilot. You know, if you've ever listened to my podcast, you've heard me say it 1,000 times. Earners are learners and leaders are readers. If you want to go to the next level, you do have to grow to the next level. And growth happens by the people you hang around and listen to the most. Seth Godin says you're the sum total of 5 people you hang around the most. And that is why you need to go to terrywilson3.com/freebook and get a free audiobook just to try out the services. Here's the deal. Over 70,000 different authors from every type of genre that you could think of. Go over there, pick one that you like, something that's going to inform you, something that's going to inspire you, something that's going to illustrate what you need to do next. Try out the service. If you don't like the service, cancel it, and you get to keep that free audiobook. But you're going to love the service, and I promise you, if you will commit yourself to listening and learning from those who have gone where you want to go, you can go there also. So go to terrywilson3.com/freebook today. Try out the service and get a free audiobook just for trying it out. terrywilson3.com/freebook.
And now back to our show with Terry Wilson.
All Well, guys, we hope you're having fun. We are having fun. We're having to learn how to do this all over again because we've been gone for 2 weeks.
We forgot how to podcast.
But anyway, listen, if you haven't subscribed to our podcast, go over to terrywilson3.com/iTunes and subscribe or sign up at Stitcher. You can go to stitcher.com, sign up for the Terry Wilson 3 podcast over there. But you'll want to do that because I've got a great podcast coming out this Thursday about 10 tips that you can use to convert more just by using graphics and stuff like that. So, Mr. River, what shout-outs do we have? I skipped over the shout-outs. I want to make sure I get those real quick.
All right. So, just a heads up, if I get your name wrong,
it's because I can't read.
It's in the blood. So don't think about
it. You've heard my dad speak, so you know I got it honest.
So, we got Reed Ducato. RJ Ken wanted to shout him out. Then we got Dedra. Jane Helms wanted to shout him out.
All right.
Then we got Darren D and Tim G. Jim Montgomery wanted to give those shout outs. And then we got a shout out for Gary Green.
All right. G backs.
Hold up. My turn.
Go right ahead, babe.
Shout out to Pedro. Shout out to Deborah and Shakita.
Pedro, Deborah, and Shakita.
Yes.
And Chris, what do you got?
Well, my man Mike Ramirez is on here. I think I already said his name.
Mike Ramirez.
He gets a second shout out.
He
was at the conference too. Good times. And then Marty, he's my new guy coming on today. And excited about Marty.
Very good. Very good. Well, it looks like we've got a bunch of people. I'm over in the chat room right now. It says A Weber rocks. Kamaya says, Greenback says, Linda, you can always use the products and tools to generate leads and mid-sized business owners leads. Absolutely. And Deidre. I see there are different systems and books. Could you expound on each and also share what's involved in each? So, yeah, absolutely, Deidre. We've got three levels of membership. Well, we actually have four. Let's start with the bottom. You can just become a sales affiliate of ours, and that's just where you have resale rights to our system. You don't have to buy anything. As a matter of fact, we give you a $1 trial on some software that you can download on your computer if you have a PC. It doesn't work for Mac. And it's a data scraper so that you can scrape leads. We give you a script to go by, and then you start calling the leads with the script we give you and all the marketing assets we give you. That's our free side. And you get paid $100 to $300. The problem with that, and I'm trying to poo-poo our sales ad affiliate position, but it's just a reality. Forbes magazine said 98% of home-based businesses fail, and the reason they fail is because you don't have a means, method, or mechanism to get in front of people. And so the power of TW3 is in this review.
I talked to hundreds of people.
You know, when you have our system, our technology, we show you how you can just start generating unlimited amount of leads. And then we show you how to resell the product or resell other products. You don't have to sell our product to make money, but we show you first and foremost how you can start generating leads and getting people work, either showing them a home-based business, as a sales affiliate, becoming a trainer here, giving them an hourly salary job, getting them, craft assembly work, getting them something in their hands so they can work. A lot of times those opportunities don't cost them anything, and you get paid to send them over there. So you've got a lead generation tool, you got a product to sell, and 90% of the products are free. So if you can't sell free, I can't help you. What do you want from me? But that's our sales affiliate. And then we go up from there. We have trainers. You have a sales rep and trainer. This is a person that all they do is resell our system. We show you how to use our system and resell our system. And if this guy had been a sales rep and trainer and left this review, I said, well, you're right. You came in at the sales rep and trainer level. That's all you do. But then we have our plus level. These are people that not only want to sell this as a business opportunity, but they want to use it as a tool to be able to generate leads for their own existing business, other businesses, be able to give things away, yada, 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 and make money. And then we have our top package, which is our elite package. This is where the money's made. This is where everybody at some point wants to be. This is where you have passive income, residual income. You have all of these different marketing assets. You have a one-on-one with me. You have our mastermind group where you're going to be around me and other people that are making this. They're making $5,000-$10,000 a week. So the deal is real, and you can really do some things there. So those are our four levels. One's our free sales affiliate, and then our three levels of trainers, and they go up from there. So that's how it works. John says, can you put 50% down and make three additional payments through TW3 directly for those whom do have the credit? Nope. We're not a bank, unfortunately, John. We do have opportunity to do lending either at cashmutualstore.com or myzippyloan.com. But we do not do financing in-house, but we do send people. And some of those lending opportunities based on the state that you're in will give you pretty good terms, even if you've got a 550 credit score. Those are good. So Ernest says, for people who cannot see, do you have a special application they can use to read the ads, like Braille application to make money? So depending on the browser you've got, Ernest, there are, Chris, you use PC, but most people use PC, but I know on Mac you can zoom in.
Well, you got two things. You can zoom in, but there's also the ability, it speaks for people who are blind. So
I don't think he's blind. I think he's just an older gentleman that's having a hard time seeing the print.
Oh, okay.
So I think that was the...
Yeah, you'd want to zoom in and
just use... It's in your browser under view, I think.
Yes. You can expand it 150, 200%. You may have to move your screen around to see everything.
Right.
But
right. And
the best thing to do, actually, if you're in that situation, is to get something like an iPad or something.
Yeah.
Because then you don't have to do that. You just use your fingers
and just pinch.
Yeah. That's the way to do it.
And so for you guys, because we have, I would say, about 15% of our membership are people that are, I would say, 65, 70 and older. And they are great salespeople. They're great marketing people. They struggle a little bit on some of the technology stuff. And the technology stuff typically they struggle with is not even our stuff. It's just basic computer stuff, you know, like that right there. And I'm not pointing out Ernest, but that's a computer thing. You know, that's not a TW3 thing. That's a computer thing. But you'll love this news I'm about to give you. We are working with a third party that all they do is computer support and lessons. They teach people basic computer skills. Ooh. With your browser, with emails and stuff like that. Because one of the things that our trainers sort of get cornered a lot of times with some people, not all people, but hey, I can't do that. And what they're needing help on, support on, is how to operate their computer. And that's not a TW3 thing. That's a computer thing. But we want our members to have that resource. So that hopefully in the next month or two will be announced and it'll be a resource. Some of it will even be free. Some of it will be at a drastic discount that'll help people. Because we realize, you know, the way to scale this business is to be able to use this technology that you have. But to use this technology, there's some skill sets that sometimes, and it's not overly complicated, and it's not a reflection on anybody's intelligence. It's not a reflection on anybody's ability to learn. It's a reflection on your experience. If you've never been around something, it's the first time you've opened something, then my word, it's going to be new to you. So cut yourself a break there. So we're going to be having that. Trevor says, Experian allows you now to add your regular utility bills and phone bills towards increasing your credit score now. Thank you, Trevor. That's a great, great piece of information there.
Yeah.
And Chris Miller says, hey, that's good info there, Trevor. I know people that will make great use of that. And Kamaya says, we're a powerhouse with each strength of our colleagues. That's exactly right, Kamaya. We've got some great guys. Do we not have just some incredible people in this business?
Oh, yeah.
We do.
And we met a lot of them at the conference. And guys, you'll want to be on next year's conference.
Yes.
I agree.
Downtown Greenville.
Going back. So, Chris is working, is it Clemson University?
Yes, so we've got a new place that I'm hoping that we can lock down. I'm in the middle of trying to work that out. So if it works out, we'll be staying at the same, you can stay at whatever hotel you want, but we'll be trying to work out a deal again because it's right across the street in building one. It's what we're
crossing
our fingers. Clemson building, yeah.
Yeah, the Clemson building. They've got a room over there.
They got several breakout rooms, big, large room.
So it's going to be, if you like downtown Greenville, which we did a blind survey, which means we don't know who said what. But we sent out a survey to all the people, and we had about 30 respondents out of the 50-some-odd that they came. And the location was great. Everybody loved the location. Everybody loved downtown Greenville. Everyone had some great comments. So we'll be talking to the speakers and the people that were participants on what we learned from this past conference, what was good and what wasn't. And Dave's on here. He says, there's nothing stronger than a like-minded group of people working to. Yes, David, if anybody knows that, a man that stands on a wall like you and your wife have, knows that intimately, and we thank you for your service again. Ion, you are worth more conference. Absolutely, Ion. And I look forward to you being one of the speakers next year as our up-and-coming new rock
Do
star.
Do not schedule me to speak during her session.
Chris, make sure you schedule in.
Make sure
go ahead and write that down.
Yeah, we do have. I've been making notes. We've got some new things planned for next year that are going to be pretty awesome. that are already in the works. So we're a year out with that stuff.
Well, guys, I can't thank all of you enough.
I got another question though, yeah, because right me and you've been talking, and I saw it got skipped over.
Hit me.
Can I use the SR&T? Me and you've talked about this quite a bit. The sales rep and trainer system to find mid-sized business owner leads.
Yeah. Well, yes, you can, but here's the deal. The SRT is you have the training and the support to be able to resell TW3 in a strategy that we give you. If you're wanting to get that sophisticated with mid-sized businesses and lead generation for this product or others, you really need to go at the plus level.
Right.
Now, what I would tell that person is come in at the SRT, start making money, and then some of the more sophisticated lead generation that you want to do, you're going to be trained on and shown how at that plus level.
Right.
Okay. So don't make perfect the enemy of good. Yeah, perfect situation. What you want right now might be at the plus level, but maybe budget restraint says I've got to be at the SRT level. So just start there, work the system where it's at, make the money there, and then graduate on up. We had, I think Chris Miller, the guy I was talking tonight, came on as a sales rep and trainer, made several thousands of dollars at that level, and then reinvested it right back into the elite level and came to the conference because he said, man, if it's that good at that level.
Right.
You know, and so... Yeah, that's the way you want to do it. Absolutely. So good stuff.
Yeah.
So, Chris, who are we going to give $300 in food away to? Hold on a second. Let me see here. Do I have any drum roll or anything here? I don't have a drum roll, so go ahead. Tell me.
I'm going to mess the name up because I shut my computer. But it's Daniel Osterman.
Daniel Osterman. And I think, Dan, if I could be, yes. Daniel, congratulations. Woo. Yes, sir. I think he's the one out in Japan. I think that's one of our members in Japan.
He's still on there.
Is Daniel on there? Let's see if Daniel's on there. But he won the $300 in free food. Yeah, we needed Bam Bam on here to do a drum roll. Absolutely. So anyway, Daniel, if you're on here, make sure you go over to terrywilson3.com/contact. Let me know that you heard the announcement, and I'll show you how to get the free food, and we'll get the certificate sent out to you. Thank all of you guys who came to the conference. My word, it was just absolutely amazing.
Yep.
You know, I thought the last year's conference was incredible, and then this year's just blew the doors off. And guys, we already pre-sold, I think, 25 tickets already.
Oh, wow.
And, you know, so we're already on target. We're hoping, you know, this year, the first year was 25. This year was 55 to 60. Next year, if we could do 100 to 150, I mean, and I don't see there's any reason why we can't at this point. And you guys that pre-bought your tickets, we're working on getting your affiliate links out to you now so you can start promoting it and selling tickets. And he said, I just need to get my money together, been doing my homework, and nothing quite like this. Kudos. Thank you so much, whoever American Basement Consulting is. I greatly appreciate it. And Quackenbush says 1,000 people next year. Well, maybe.
Whoa.
Mark, your faith is bigger than mine, brother, but I'll take it, man.
But it was the cross learning that was most interesting. It wasn't just the sessions and stuff, but watching people help each other.
Yes.
And, right.
And even the groups of people like Mark's folks that came and all of them that are grouping up at kind of now getting to meet each other. It was just really kind of cool.
It was very cool for all of the trainers to be there, our elite guys, and seeing them connect with their people already. And like I said, just 1 week has passed. We're only a week out, and we've got 5 people that never made a sale in the business. Some, and I'm not going to mention names because it's irrelevant. Some of them had been with us for 4 years.
Wow.
One person had been with us for 4 years, never made a sale, came to conference, got on fire, made his first sale.
That's what it happens though.
And because it just clicked. It just clicked. And then others just started a month ago or 2 months ago. But they got to the conference 3 months ago, 6 months ago. But they're working and learning the system. And so it's great. So Ernest says the ads in the back office look great, colorful, and lively. Great. Thanks. And Quackenbush says sometimes success is caught, not taught. You have said that many times, and I have quoted you on it. And this is Sid Spencer. My ABC came from listening to you guys. doing what I can to prepare good stuff. Well, thank you so much, Spencer. Sid, we look forward to working with you. Ian says three P's of marketing, 1990s. Hey, thank you. Remember, guys, remember what I told you in the opening session. If you'll do this if you'll do these six things for 90 days, 90 minutes a day, you're putting the numbers in your favor. You can't help but be successful. Greenback says, I had a private training in my hotel room at the TW3 conference. And I know your guys walked out jacked up, Greenback, seeing your numbers and seeing what you do. So I know it was of great value. Chuck says, way to go, G. Chuck, it was great meeting you as well at the conference. So, guys, thank you for coming out tonight. Thank you for being on our podcast. Thank you for being a member of TW3. Thank you for even considering being a member of TW3. Even if you don't join, I want to leave you with this. Maybe I'm not right for you. Maybe this business isn't right for you. But don't sell yourself short. Don't sell yourself short. Maybe right now all you need is an hourly salary job or something. Let one of my reps help you get that. But work toward having your own thing, because I do believe everybody was created for, by, and with the purposes of greatness. You're not a cosmic accident.
You're not, speaking of cosmic accidents,
Chris over here just
right in the middle of a great, I mean, he's like delivering this special moment. And then see, boom.
See, Chris, in the church world, this is what we call the altar call. This is when we get a little more solid.
I know what's going on. I'm very familiar with it. My ring went up and hit the mic really hard.
Got it.
I appreciate you just peeing right all over my
heart. That was so bad. That was so...
My last appeal for them to do something great.
Do something great. What Terry is trying to say is don't screw this up. You got like one life to live.
You got one life to live.
And right at that moment, your special moment, don't hit the mic.
Preach to them, preacher.
Don't hit the mic.
No, seriously, guys, you can do more because you are worth more. And we thank you for coming out tonight. And we hope that we can take your money, your business, your life to new levels if you'll give us the opportunity. Talk to you later.
Thank you for listening to our show today at TerryWilson3.com. If you would like more information on how we can take your money, your business, and your life to the next level, then please visit us online at TerryWilson3.com or call 800-673-1728.
This is the Terry Wilson. Really? I'm excited, Terry. I want to get started here.
Is this a celebrity, Terry Wilson?
Oh, my word.
How you doing, sir?
Dude, don't even go there. I've been listening to this for a while, and I'm finally like, okay, guys, what a privilege. I mean,